Hello, this is a short Qigong warm-up that will hopefully allow you to be more integrated with your arms and your juggling into your body. Would be great to know what you think about this sequence, and thanks for watching. So, breathe in, open arms, sides. Arms rotated outwards for a little while, breathing deeply. Okay. Now to really awaken the awareness into our shoulders in these movements and to start the movement deep in the joint, you put a hand on the shoulder and feel the bone as the arm turns outwards and inwards. You can sort of feel it clicking and popping away in there. But the brain receives these images, these impulses. Okay, then turn it out and keeping the shoulder relaxed, feeling the bone outwards, right, raise the hand. And then just very gently increase the stretch. And then bring the shoulder down. And the other side, the hand on the shoulder, rotate outwards and inwards a few times. And then leave the hand out and bring the shoulder up. Very gently, and then slightly increase the stretch. And again, the hand on the shoulders, and down, and down. This seems like a very simple exercise, but already I feel that I've created a lot more space within the articulation. So now, draw the fingers down to the ground and the back of the neck, we raise it up high. Shoulders down, breathe deeply. And then raising, scooping the hands up, keeping the back of the neck long. We feel the whole of the back lengthening. And then raising the hands more. And then turning the hands out, pushing outwards. This exercise, I like to call it the juggler's nightmare, because it really touches all those tensions that juggling causes in the arms, and it also helps to release all of those tensions, preventing injury and pain in the shoulders and the arms. Breathing deeply, and then bring your arms back in again, keeping the neck long in the back, then the hands down, and then down again. You can repeat this a number of times. You're going to just go up once more, so scoop the hands up again, feel the arms connected to the back, and then up again, feeling how stretches the higher back, and then the hands out again. And breathe, and then reaching out with the fingers, really from within the joints, within here, feeling space being created. And then within, from in the joints, we turn the shoulders outwards. Really from in here, it's not just the hands, you know, it's that really full rotation outwards. And this position, this exercise is really very good at releasing all those tensions in the shoulders. We want to really drop our shoulders down and breathe. And from the shoulders, turn the hands the other way around. And the other way around. And then one hand down. And then alternating. Okay, and then bring the shoulders down. Feel how already the shoulders are much warmer and how more connected the arms are to the body. Now, because often we think the arms are just attached to the body here, but they really go deep inside all of our chest. No? And the more we awaken this awareness into there, the more we can juggle and use our body efficiently. Okay, so open our legs, just a few more other exercises. One hand into the ground, the ear touching the shoulder. Nice deep breath. Raise your hands up into the air. And flat back, bending the legs, bringing the elbows in. Turning the head left and right. And head up and down. And turning the body sideways. And coming up again. Breath. Now hands like clouds. To connect the arms better to the body, you want to move from the hips. And the hands stay more or less always in front of the chest. Hands are very light, supported by the back muscles, not really about shoulders. No, this would be not really the right way to do it. It's about supporting the weight of the arms and the belly and on the back. After we've done this about a million times, you might start to feel really the lightness in the hands. A million times, maybe 10 million times. Okay, just a few more exercises that I'd like to share. Just holding onto a rope and pulling it down to the ground. This is really very good at connecting the movement to our centre. Pull down and the arms go up on their own. Very liberating and integrating the arms and the body. Okay. there's about, well, I don't know, there's many, many other exercises we could do, but that would be enough for now. Thank you for watching.